Assalamu alaikum. This is Dr. Fatah Rahman Rashid, System Professor of Obstetric and Gynecology. In this video, we'll discuss the lecture about green top guideline of antenatal corticosteroid to reduce neonatal morbidity and mortality. Background. There is evidence to suggest that the antenatal corticosteroids are effective in reducing respiratory distress syndrome, RDS, intraventricular hemorrhage, IVH, what are the benefits of antenatal corticosteroids? Antenatal steroids are associated with significant reduction in the rate of neonatal death, respiratory distress syndrome, and intraventricular hemorrhage and RC for the mother. Studies show that the treatment of women at risk of preterm births with single course of antenatal corticosteroid reduced the risk of neonatal death by 31%, respiratory distress syndrome by 44%, and intraventricular hemorrhage by 46%. Also, antenatal corticosteroid associated with reduction in necrotizing enterocolitis, need of respiratory support, intensive care admission, systemic infection in the first 48 hours of life. Antenatal corticosteroids have no known benefit for the mother. At what gestation should antenatal steroids be used? Offer a single course of antenatal corticosteroid to women between 24 weeks and 34 weeks plus 6 days of gestation who are at risk of preterm births. Antenatal corticosteroid can be considered for women between 23 weeks and 23 plus 6 days of gestation who are at risk of preterm births. The decision to administer corticosteroid at gestation less than 24 weeks should be made at senior level, taking all the clinical aspects into consideration. How long after administration is a course of antenatal course most effective? Antenatal corticosteroids are most effective in reduced respiratory distress syndrome in pregnancy that deliver 24 hours after and up to 7 days after administration of the second dose of antenatal corticosteroid. Antenatal corticosteroid used to reduce neonatal death within the first 24 hours and therefore should still be given even if delivery is expected with this time. How safe is the use of antenatal corticosteroid? Single course of antenatal corticosteroid does not appear to be associated with any significant short-term maternal or fetal adverse effect. No clear evidence of any difference in adverse neurological or cognitive effect versus placebo. Insufficient evidence on the longer term benefit and risk of multiple course of antenatal corticosteroid. Are there any contraindications to the use of antenatal corticosteroid? Caution should be exercised when given corticosteroid therapy to the woman with systemic infection including tuberculosis or sepsis. No evidence that single course of corticosteroid would have profound effect in women with systemic infection, but caution should be exercised. Senior opinion should be soft when the complementing delayed delivery for the steroid prophylaxis in case of overt chorioamnionitis. Clinical chorioamnionitis associated significantly with increase in the incidence of both systemic periventricular leukemia and cerebral palsy, so course of antenatal corticosteroid may be started but should not delay delivery if indicated by maternal or fetal condition. Who should receive antenatal corticosteroid? All women at risk of iatrogenic or spontaneous preterm births up to 34 weeks plus 6 days of gestation A. All women for who an elective caesarean section is planned prior to 38 weeks plus 6 days of gestation. No evidence to support practice prophylactic steroid in women's previous history of preterm delivery or multiple pregnancies who show no sign of being at risk of iatrogenic or spontaneous preterm labor. A single course of antenatal corticosteroid should be considered routine for preterm delivery with few exceptions. Over a single course of antenatal corticosteroid treatment to women with multiple pregnancies at risk of imminent iatrogenic or spontaneous preterm delivery between 24 weeks and 34 weeks plus 60 days of gestation. Optimal dose not clearly understood. Diabetes mellitus is not contraindication to antenatal corticosteroid treatment for fetal lung maturation. Women with impaired glucosterol or diabetes who are receiving fetal steroids should have additional insulin according to the agreed protocol and be closely monitored. In women undergoing elective caesarean section, elective lower segment caesarean section should normally be performed at or after 39 weeks of gestation to reduce respiratory morbidity. Corticosteroids should be given to reduce the risk of respiratory morbidity in all babies delivered by elective caesarean section prior to 38 weeks plus 6 days of gestation. Elective caesarean section less than 39 weeks of gestation can lead to respiratory morbidity in neonate requiring admission to NICU. IUGR between 24 weeks and 35 weeks plus 6 days at risk of delivery should receive a single course of antenatal corticosteroid. Antenatal corticosteroid have effect on cerebral blood flow in cross-restricted fetus that is different from the normal fetus should be used in such fetus. What is the best dose and route of administration for course of antenatal corticosteroid? Betamethasone 12 mg given intramuscularly in 2 doses or dexamethasone 6 mg given intramuscularly in 4 doses are the steroid of choice to enhance lung maturation. With betamethasone, the following are less than with dexamethasone: neonatal cystic preventricular leukomalacia, lower neonatal death, larger reduction in respiratory distress syndrome. However, dexamethasone decreased the incidence of intraventricular hemorrhage compared to betamethasone. When should antenatal course of corticosteroid be repeated? Weekly repeat course of antenatal corticosteroid reduces the occurrence and severity of neonatal respiratory disease, but the short-term benefit are associated with reduction in weight and head circumference. Weekly repeat course are not recommended. A single rescue course may be considered with the caution in pregnancy, where the initial course was given at less than 26 weeks of gestation. Senior opinion should be sought if a rescue course is to be considered. A senior opinion should be sought if a rescue course is to be considered. A rescue course of 2 doses of 12 mg betamethasone or 4 doses of 6 mg dexamethasone should only be considered with caution in those pregnancies where the first course was given at less than 26 weeks of gestation and another obstetric indication arises later in pregnancy. Thank you.